Like, I'm waiting for a bus here, but that one is already passed, and this one's supposed to be here. Don't you just dislike that? Rabbi Ramadan, be Ramadan, Arhamna. Fubu Alaina. Like, I've been waiting for this bus for the past 4 minutes now, and it's supposed to be here. Like, 1 or 2 minutes ago. If I had known, I would have went down there. Because this house I'm standing on, look at how they do their plans. Like, damn, people got time. Yeah, the one I have at my house is not even growing. Well, it's growing, but the other ones haven't grown. The sun is shining brightly on my face and I feel good. Like, I feel good. Da, 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 da. Honestly, I don't understand this process. Like, no, I don't understand it. Ah, and it's so sunny. Oh, yes. I'm going to the BlackFest happening in Calgary. And apparently, AY is in Calgary today. Like, the AY comedian is in Calgary today. And I'm like, ah. I don't know about AY in Calgary, but I know about this BlackFest. And that's how, and that's why I'm going out today. I'll need to find another bus to take me, because this one is not coming. Yeah, AY is in Calgary and I don't know. My sister is actually just telling me about it. And I'm like, oh, is it free? You know, we do like that, do all those free events. But I would like to go, because one time, I know I've been to Basket Mouth. I mean, like, we had this virtual Shea Brown once, like, during the COVID, we have the virtual one. And also, what's his name? I forgot his name. Black. Oh, yeah, Yemi Black. Am I right? Yemi Black? Is that his name? Yeah, he had a virtual comedian, Brown, whatever. Like during the COVID, and then what else? Who else? Yeah, that's all I've been to. But I've never been to AY, so it would be nice if I can go. If someone can pitch in, I'll see if I can go actually. I'm at the other side now of the bus stop, and I hope it comes. This is why I need a car. So I'm finally here, and well, I have no idea it's gonna be this. Okay, let's check this out. Well, it's something nice. I'm gonna feel my face on.
Make the show great. Ladies and gentlemen, if I can have your attention, please. Welcome down. Are you guys enjoying yourselves so far at this amazing Black Inclusivity Festival? Get excited. Now listen, to show these comedians what kind of crowd we're walking into tonight. 3, 2, 1, let me hear you. That's amazing. Let's get this started. E. Sterling Scott, originally from Trinidad and Tobago, by way of Edmonton. Anybody Caribbean here? Just, okay, the one. All right, where's my African people? All right, let's get this settled. Who makes the best jollof rice? Like, we need that.
Nigeria.
You see how fast we got divided? Right there. This one lady sat down and said Senegal, and everybody was like, you don't even count. Like, if you were cheering for your soccer team, maybe, but if you make a good fufu, I don't know. People, I'm glad that you're here. Now listen, I'm Sterling, it's a pleasure. I am a professional stand-up comedian here in Canada, and it's very difficult. You know why? I see babies in the crowd, that's fantastic. Hello, little babies. I'm a father, I have 3 kids. I have 3. Yeah, they don't care about me. I'm just not going to say anything they can repeat later. Because I have 3 kids. But whenever I go away, I don't know if you ever do this, ma'am. Do you ever tell them how long you're gone by sleeps? Do you ever be like, no, you don't even get to sleep. You're like, no. Whenever I leave sleeps, I'm going to go away. And I've been on tour for 6 weeks. I had to say, yeah. And I say, yeah. They're only 4. So they look up and they say, hey, daddy, daddy, who is your bestest best friend? Dad, that's a deep question. Think about that for a second. Who is your bestest best? I don't know who my bestest best friend is. So I turn it on my daughter. I say, who's your bestest best friend? And she looks up at me and she goes, me and you, daddy. Me and you. I was like, you're not even in my top 5. You're a terrible friend. You don't drink, you don't drive. Shut up, you're not my friend. You're independent. That's what I put on my taxes. Listen, I'm not a bad person, but I ain't a good one. I got kicked out of Chuck E. Cheese. Now it's not my fault. Here's the reason. No, if you've been to Chuck E. Cheese, then you know this. They serve alcohol. You can't do that. There's a demon inside of me. Okay, there's Sober Sterling and Drunk Sterling, okay? Sober Sterling stands before you tonight, right? Sober Sterling has a mortgage, car payments, responsibilities! Drunk Sterling has none of those things. But he has the access codes to my debit and credit card. 6 drinks at Chuck E. Cheese, it looks exactly like a nightclub. My son's like, Daddy, when are we going home? I'm like, home? We shutting this place down! I got drunk. I don't know if you guys ever been to Chuck E. Cheese, but at some point during the night, Chucky comes out. You know what I'm talking about. Chucky comes out, huh? And he has 2 girls with him in a boombox. All right? And he starts dancing, and what does he do? What does he do? He tries to insult me while I'm drunk by taking his bucket with coupons in it and making it rain on all the children. I'm way too drunk for this. I'm like, no, you will not outshine me. I took my own kids' coupons and started making it rain on all the other little kids. And I was like, who's your daddy now? And they threw me out because their parents were there. So. It's hard. I see a lot of young people, and that's beautiful. How old are you? 36. I look like I started it. You look like you're about to fix something. I look like I'm on a chain yelling, that's not my name. All right, if you laughed at that, you're old like me. That's a Roots reference, okay? That's a Roots reference. I love it. It's hard. I don't bother to lie. I don't bother. I don't like it. I don't care. I like older women. Where's my women over 30? Clap. Yeah. You're the ones I love. Don't you be shamed. I love you. I don't want no young woman. You have an older woman. She gonna take care of you. She gonna look after you. She gonna be there for you through the hard times and the good. You have a young woman. She just gonna make a TikTok video. I ain't gonna do nothing with that. I need more in my life. I need. I have 3 kids and I'm single. That's a terrible resume. I know, you see, look, but you are looking at it and you say it, but all the men are like, what? I don't understand. Why? That's a bad, listen, I'll tell you, when you have 3 kids and a single, they know 2 things about you. One, you have commitment issues and a weak pullout game. Now, here's the thing. If you're mad, if your kid knows what that means, you're the one at fault. They should not know what that word means. See how uncomfortable it got for that word? Comics, you understand? You can't even say that word. Okay, I have a few more funnies to say to you guys. Just so that I could be in your face so that we can enjoy. All right? And have we not had fun so far, everybody? Right, and I'm just your host. I'm just your host. The rest of the show is going to be much, much better. So with that being said, let me tell one more before I go. All right, there we go. That's the one. Attention. But if you guys see what I look like regularly, I have a big afro, it's huge, big out to here. And I was walking and she saw me and she goes, I got a winner. Oh, she got out from behind that poop, clipboard in her hand. She asserted herself, looks directly at me. Sir! Excuse me, sir! 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 Would you like to sponsor an African child? And I was like, no. She was shocked. She didn't know how to respond. She was just like, what? And I was like, let me get this straight. You want me to make monthly payments to a black child I'm never going to see? I'm already doing that. Okay. You see, that's a silly joke. It was a fun joke, okay? If you didn't laugh at that joke, you're still living through that trauma. But like, you've got to understand, it's during a horrible time and I said it to get some hee-hees and ha-has to make this world beautiful again. This woman did not hee-hee. She starts shouting at me in the mall. Why don't you want to help your own people? That's what she said. That's what she said. Everything I say in my head is hilarious. And I was like, well, let me get this straight. You want me to sponsor a child? What happens when you sponsor a child? I'll tell you. First thing they're going to do is they're going to send you a picture of that child. You get a picture of that child, what do? You put it on your fridge. Right? If I put a picture of an African child on my fridge, just looks like my kid. You know what I mean? You better come to my house, look at the fridge, look at me, and be like, eat your kid. They're going to think that's what I do. I just fly out to third world countries, make love to women, come back to Canada, watch commercials like, there he is right there. That's my boy right there! Are y'all ready to get this comedy show started? Let me hear you! When I introduce these comedians, I need you guys to laugh, clap, and lose your minds because they are here tonight with only one thing on their mind, and that's to make y'all happy. With that being said, your first comedian coming to the stage is very dear to my heart because this comedian made history in being the first and only black-owned comedy country out of Alberta. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for Chris!
Hey guys, how are we doing? How's everybody feeling? This is good. I love this. We made an event to like unify black people, and then Sterling came and said, hey, who makes the best giraffe? Easily the most divisive force in Western Africa. And he's like, yeah, here, let's unify these people. I'm pretty sure giraffe is how Boko Haram started. I think one guy was like, hey man, those Ghanaians might be up to something. They're like, we're gonna kill everybody. This is nuts, man. This is good. I'm happy to be here, man. I'm happy, this is the most black people I've ever performed in front. I know, there's like 12. It's weird. Most of the rooms I perform in look like the auction scene in Get Out. Like, it's... You know the one where Keith Stanfield starts crying? That one. So, really, this is a joy. This is a pleasure. It's great to be back here too in Vancouver, or in Calgary. I was in Vancouver recently. Vancouver for its diversity. You ever get like, dude, you gotta go to Vancouver. It's so diverse, you're gonna love it. I was like, all right, cool. I go out there to perform, try to be around my own kind, and I'm gonna report back, no black people there either. None. I know this because it took me a week to see one. It took me a week, and then I see him, right? I see him, and then he gives me the signal. Right? This is what black people do when there aren't a lot of other black people. So we see each other from across the street, right? We make eye contact. We see each other. I look at him. He looks back at me. I look back at him. He looks back at me. I look back at him. He looks back at me. And I was like, please don't do it. And then he went. And I was like, damn it, here too, huh? Here too. He was like, yep, absolutely. Absolutely, here too. It's just us, baby. Oh, I guess they heard about the event. Okay. I guess they heard about it. What's BlackFest without a little popo? All right, okay. What's BlackFest without law enforcement? All right. Happy to be here. Thank you for having me. Stretching my legs. This is good. This is good. All right, everybody run. Yeah, no, the signal's funny because I think, guys, we gotta stop doing that. We gotta stop doing it. It's making all the white people think we all know each other. We gotta cut that one out. But no, it's nice, man. I love doing stand-up. Been doing it now a couple years all over Western Canada. I used to play soccer. You know what I mean? Because, like, white people are very, like, methodical, right? Very structured in how they're very systematic. Like, they count when they dance. You know what I mean? Very systematic in how they like to do things. Black people, we're a lot more feeling, right? We're a lot more rhythm, right? We like to do things based on what it feels like. Unless it's like kayaking, whitewater rafting, cruises, basically anything boat related. We want all the details, but like other than that, pretty whimsical people. You know, but man, I love shaking hands with white dudes. I love it. Because when I do it, I don't think anything of it. I just throw my hand up, right? Hey man, what's good? You look at him, you see the wheels start to turn. You know what I mean? Right? The hand goes up, he's like, all right, freeze frame. Okay, elbows at an acute angle, hands facing up. This isn't a business shake. Ethan, you practice this. Right? The hands lock, the eyes light up. He's like, oh my god, I'm in? Oh, I've only seen this in rap videos. I can't wait to... Right. And he's like, oh my god, he's pulling me in? We're gonna bump shoulders. I can't wait to tell all my friends. And he's like, I think he's gonna let me say nigga. I think he's gonna let me do it. Careful, look at us. One step at a time. We might. Maybe next time. We throw maybe a little backhand in there. I might give you one. You know, but you know, we gotta take baby steps with all of it. Anyway, any East Africans out here? Hey? That was. I'm calling. I think we're done. Oh no. No. I'm just talking trash. I date a lot of white girls. Guys. All right, potential suitor. Thank you. But guys, I live in Lethbridge. You gotta take what the defense gives you. All right, come on. Can't go with nothing. I was with a white girl. It was a pretty interesting interaction. You guys can maybe help me make sense of this. So. We're talking, she stops me, she goes, Sarah? This is my white girl impression. The white girls, they always talk like they're carrying a plate of food. And then, when they say something weird, they drop it. Y'all ever see us? They're like, yeah, of course he has feelings for you. He's just overwhelmed by his emotions. You know that stuff. This girl saw, she goes, Ferris, I have a dilemma and I require your diverse perspective. I have a friend from, he's from Tabor, Alberta. All right, he's Filipino. Surprising number of Filipinos in Tabor. He works at a Tim Hortons. And customers are always coming in and complimenting him on his English accent. Now this bothers him because he was born there. The accent is natural to him. He calls it a microaggression. I think people are just trying to be nice. What do you think, Ferris? Comment your accent. I said, obviously that's bullshit, right? There's no such thing as a surprising number of Filipinos. Like, they travel in packs. They're like, they're everywhere. Actually, you know what a surprising number of Filipinos is? One. That's a surprising number of Filipinos. Sarah, I was banking on you maybe being Filipino, am I right? Half. And look at us. Surprised.